Hi, I'm Zadi Diaz here at the PBS press tour with Patti Smith.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. Thank you for joining us. We're talking about today about the Patti Smith Dream of Life documentary that's airing for the POV series for PBS. Do you want to talk to us a little bit about what it is and how it kind of came about?
Well, I can't tell you exactly what it is, but I can tell you how it came about. It was 1995. I had lost my husband and my brother. I had two children, and I had to start a new life and come back east from Detroit. And it was time for me to make a living, take care of my kids, and to start my life over again. And I found that the best thing I could do, the most encouraging thing I could do, and the best way to make a living was to go back to performing. Mm-hmm. And in the course of this, I met Steven Sebring, and we did a photo shoot together. And he was such a, it was really, truthfully, it was like God had decided to give me another brother. From the moment I met him, he's so family-oriented. He's an artist. He's creative. He's got huge amounts of energy. He wanted to learn more about me. He met me as a mother. Mm-hmm. He met me as an artist that he had to shoot for Spin, and he really didn't know so much about my music. And when he saw me perform, he told me he was trying to factor the mother and the performer. And so he asked if he could film me and sort of learn about me as he was filming. And I normally I wouldn't have done this, but the fact that he wanted to do it as a sort of a learning experience intrigued me. He wasn't out to do a rock and roll documentary. He wasn't out to do something historic. He wasn't trying to place me in any box. He just wanted to, I guess, see what made me tick.
Right.
I don't know if you found that.
How was that process, though? You're kind of letting someone else into your personal life. You're kind of just exposing yourself. I would imagine as an artist that you do that on a continual basis, but was this a little different for you?
Well, it was actually fun because I had such a difficult time, and having to go back on tour, the encouragement of other people was helpful. I mean, the first tour I had was opening Bob Dylan, and Bob Dylan was encouraging, and I had met Michael Stipe, and he came along to help me get back. You know, I hadn't performed in 16 years.
Right.
And so I had all of these good people rallying around me, and you know, Oliver Ray and Lenny Kaye and Tom Verlaine and you know, all of the people that worked with me, my whole camp, they just rallied, and we did everything we could to make it productive and fun. And and having Steven with his one 16mm camera dragging that, you know, on his shoulder, you know, for me, gave it a little don't look back appeal.
Right.
Gave me something to play off of, and that could be potentially serious and potentially artistic, but also fun.
Was that... after you saw the film, did you feel like it portrayed you in the light that you would have imagined, or did you feel like it revealed something of you that perhaps you didn't quite see for yourself?
I actually recognized myself.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, at first it was a little hard to keep watching myself. You know, I kept saying, put more people, put other things in it. You know, I felt a little embarrassed, but as I got more comfortable, with you know, seeing the footage, I seemed like me to me, you know. I just
Well, what do you want? What would you say do you want people to kind of get out of it if you're saying, hey, this is me, this is Patti Smith, or this is just Patti? I don't know, like, what is the one thing that you would want people to kind of feel like they're uncovering about you?
Well, I think that I have a sense of humor, that, I'm a deeply flawed individual, but, you know, I have, I'm a hard worker. Mm-hmm. I think I'm a good worker. I try to be a good mom. And, the film, it puts the work that I've been involved with in some historic perspective, but it was in time.
Right.
And, it portrays me as a mother, as a daughter, as a writer, as a person who's a concerned citizen, and hopefully sometimes funny. So, I'm happy with the film. There isn't anything that isn't in it, that I feel that, people should know or they need to see to get a richer sense of who I am. Mm-hmm. At this time in my life, I mean, it was shot between the ages of 50 and 60. Mm-hmm. So I also think that that's a good thing. I mean, when you're younger, at least when I was younger, I was more susceptible to being shot. I liked being filmed. I liked getting mm-hmm. my picture taken. I was better looking, more photogenic. But besides that, I think in a way it's kind of nice to show people that, at a certain time period in your life, that one is still energetic, productive, insightful, and can cause at least a small amount of disturbance. So,
and that there is beauty in every age.
Yeah, there is. I mean, I like these years have been, coming out of like the worst period of my life and such a sad, sad period. I think that the film is positive. It's a happy film. I mean, Fred is with us. I feel that, I don't feel his absence. I feel his presence.
Right.
And I like that very much. It was a surprise, actually. When I first saw the film, it made me cry. Because mm-hmm. I thought, somehow, Steven, who never met Fred, managed to make certain that Fred mm. was a part of the film.
Mm. No, you just came out of tour, like we were talking about earlier,
yeah.
A month and a half. So obviously,
I'm so inarticulate. I'm really sorry.
No, you're very articulate, and it seems like you're just a force of nature. You keep on going. Now, as an artist, I would imagine you ask an artist, and they never stop doing what they're doing. But so, what would be next for you? What do you envision the next few years of your life being?
Well, the next thing I want to do is record. I want to do another album with my core band, but also with the people that I've met in the past few years. I want to do something with Kevin Shields from My Bloody Valentine, with Flea, Tom Verlaine, hopefully with Michael, and some of the classical musicians I've met. I'm really interested in seeing, what we all can come up with. I'm very excited. I want to work with my son and daughter.
Mm-hmm.
I feel excited about the next record. I have a lot of ideas. I just finished a book about my early years with Robert Mapplethorpe,
mm-hmm.
and our life together from 67 to 75, and so I'm hoping that that'll be a nice book for people, because it really addresses being young and struggling and having a vision of things and struggling to maintain, but also to develop that sense of vision. So I hope it's also funny, but I'm interested in working on an opera, you know. I use the term opera a little loosely, but I'd like to write a song cycle. I want to pursue my visual work. I have a couple of short film ideas, nothing real ambitious, but there's a lot of things I want to do. I'm very fortunate because my son and daughter are now grown, and they're both productive, they're both healthy, and I feel confident that, you know, I can sort of go my way and they'll do fine. So I have a lot more time to develop a lot of ideas that I've sort of shelved in the past couple decades.
Well, we're really looking forward to seeing what the next few years and decades bring. So thank you so much for spending some time and talking about
thank
what
you.
You're doing.
I'm very proud that the film is going to be on POV. It was one of the things that kept us going, especially Steven, who had to shoulder most of the responsibility including the financial responsibility of this film, and knowing that public television was interested in it was really inspiring. And it's showing on my birthday. What could be better?
Happy birthday.
Yeah. That's right. So December 30th, the birthday of Bo Diddley, Rudyard Kipling, Paul Bowles, and myself.
Some greats. Good company.
Thanks.
So if you want to find out more about the film, make your way to pbs.org. Thanks again.
Bye.